Did you know that Boeing had once been working on a shortened three-engine variant to the 747? Nowadays, it's hard to imagine the Boeing 747 as anything other than a four-engine icon. However, in the 1960s and 1970s, Boeing was considering constructing a three-engine variant of the type. This trijet aircraft would have had one engine under either wing, with an additional engine mounted on the tail. This design would have been similar to the narrow-body Boeing 727, although obviously much larger. The Boeing 747 trijet would have been significantly shorter than the base 747. It was designed to compete with contemporary wide-body trijet airliners, namely the Lockheed L-1011 and the McDonnell Douglas DC-10. The aircraft would have had a greater passenger capacity, payload, and range than both of these prospective competitors. However, the proposal was ultimately unsuccessful due to two key factors. For this new aircraft to have been structurally sound, it would have required a brand new wing design. This is because the contemporary wing design was made for two engines on either side. Pilot training requirements were the second factor in the project's failure. Boeing was aiming to create a product that was almost identical to its regular 747 in terms of pilot operation. Wanting to require minimal training for the conversion to the three-engine variant, Boeing was hoping to maintain the existing handling characteristics. This proved hard for the company to achieve. Boeing didn't completely abandon the trijet variant of the 747, however. Instead of continuing development with three engines, the manufacturer created a shorter 747 with the conventional four engines. This was named the 747SP, with the suffix standing for Special Performance. Entering service in 1976 with Pan Am, Boeing built a total of 45 747SP aircraft. According to Planespotters.net, six of these aircraft are still in operation today. Boeing's trijet variant of the 747 ultimately never had a chance to compete with the Lockheed L-1011 and the McDonnell Douglas DC-10. However, towards the end of the 20th century, McDonnell Douglas launched a second-generation trijet airline, the MD-11. Its basic configuration was similar to that of the older DC-10, however, it benefited from updated engines, a longer fuselage, and wider wings. Having seen the fate of the MD-11 as a passenger airline, Boeing can perhaps be said to have dodged a bullet by not producing the trijet 747. Nonetheless, it would undoubtedly have made for a curious sight in the skies had it actually come to fruition. Did Boeing make the right call scrapping its 747 trijet concept? Let us know what you think in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.